Good morning and welcome. My name is Megan Balda. I am the executive director with the Greater Twin Cities Youth Symphonies, and we are just so delighted to be here with all of you this morning. Thank you for taking time to join us on this busy weekend. We are switching things up a little bit for our three concerts. Over today and tomorrow. I've been thinking that it would be really wonderful to hear a little more from our students and to hear their voices. And so with me today, we have a symphony student. His name is Arlo Hollander, and he will be extending his welcome on behalf of the GTCYS students.
Hello, everyone. My name is Arlo Hollander. I'm a senior from Robbinsville Cooper High School. This is my second year as a trombonist in GTCYS and the Symphony Orchestra. First and foremost, welcome to everybody here in the audience today, as well as everyone tuning in from the live stream. Before I talk more about the performance you'll hear today, I do have a few acknowledgments. Thank you to our parents, guardians, and family members for supporting your children, whether it's taking your kid to rehearsal, showing up to their concerts, or listening to them practice for all hours of the night. That goes out to my parents. We really, truly appreciate it, and that's whether your kid says that or not. Thank you to our music educators for teaching us and furthering our knowledge of music. Thank you to our wonderful volunteers for being willing to share your time and talents. Thank you to our alumni and donors who make it possible for students to perform in this amazing hall, learn from wonderful artistic leaders, and provide scholarships. Lastly, thank you to my fellow GTCYS students for all of your hard work and commitment this year to making great music. The people that you will see that are wearing white carnations are our GTCYS student mentors, and the 89 amazing graduating seniors that you'll see are wearing red carnations. And if you would like to learn more about them, you can read more in the lobby. A special thank you goes out to Maestro Smith and the entirety of the GTCYS administration, wonderful GTCYS staff, for all of their hard work in putting together this event. Thank you so much. Oh. While I've only been in GTCYS for 2 years, I do have a lot to be thankful for. And when I joined the Symphony Orchestra last year, I was really nervous because I didn't know anyone. I'm from Robbinsdale, you know, a little small Minneapolis suburb, and I didn't really know anyone. And when I showed up to the first rehearsal, what I didn't know is that all the people that I would be surrounded with would become some of my closest friends. And GTCYS really provided me with the opportunity to make really amazing connections with really amazing people. And being surrounded with such great musicians really pushed me to be better. And so I practiced with that kind of goal in mind. My hard work paid off and my practice made me better, and that enabled me to pursue my dreams in music, but I really attribute much of that to GTCYS. And as many of you know, last year the Symphony Orchestra embarked on a tour of Southern Italy. And as someone who went on that tour, I can really say that it was a really life-changing experience, and one that holds some of my favorite memories. But GTCYS is what really holds my favorite memories. And so thank you, GTCYS, for letting me be a part of this wonderful organization, letting me meet these wonderful people, and letting me play this wonderful music. Thank you. Emotional stuff over. Okay, in this performance, you will hear 4 of the 10 GTCYS orchestras, Philharmonia West, Sinfonia West, Concert Orchestra, and Symphony, ending with a combined performance. Please remember to silence any of your devices so our performance can focus, and if you need to leave the concert hall, please do so in between the orchestras. Most importantly, enjoy the performance. Thank you.
We are so excited to be here, celebrating another season of music, friends, new adventures, and more music. Thank you, parents and family members, for your help, support, time, and resources. Thank you, students, for an amazing year. You have grown so much, and Monday evenings have truly been a highlight of my week. You have shown courage, kindness, and a great willingness to try and learn new things. We are sharing two pieces with you this morning. The first, Duologue, was commissioned by GTCYS in 2016 for Philharmonia East and West. Duologue was composed by the amazing Twin Cities composer, musician, and teacher, Bob Adney. I do believe Bob is in the audience this morning. Bob, could you stand? Our percussionist is none other than GTCYS operations manager and percussionist extraordinaire, Adam Rappel. This piece is really a conversation between the percussionist and the orchestra. There is much conversation or duologue between these two sections. Watch closely towards the end, as there will be an opportunity for you, the audience, to join in on this conversation. Watch for my cue. Our final piece is Wood Splitter Fanfare by Brian Balmages. This piece was written specifically for a student who had the misfortune of dropping her viola during a concert. Unfortunately, the instrument cracked, thus the title, Wood Splitter Fanfare. Let's welcome our soloist, Adam Rappel.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Laura Hebert, and I have the privilege of conducting Sinfonia West. And this group hit the ground running from day one. I could tell they were excited to be there, they were ready to work hard, they were ready to make music, and they practiced at home. So that allowed us right from the get-go to start working on the musical aspects, the phrasing, the dynamics, who has the melody, and if you don't have the melody, what should you be doing? And they really rose to the occasion. I worked them hard. I think that was a term we used a lot. We worked hard, but I think it really paid off, and I've really enjoyed this group. So parents, teachers, guardians, thank you for dedicating this time. And I know every week you guys have to show up and drive in that carpool line and encourage practicing, even when they don't want to. I get that's a thing. And we couldn't do it without you. So thank you so much for being here today and showing up every week, because we can't do it without you. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Jack Reinertsen, and I have the privilege of leading the GTCYS Concert Orchestra as their conductor. This spring festival is the culmination of a wonderful year for us, and I'm so proud of these students and how hard they have worked over the past 9 months. Students who play music learn more than you think they do. The arts teach us many basic skills that are valued highly in our society. Patience, literacy, commitment, and teamwork all come to mind. And although these things are very, very valuable, I believe that studying music teaches us unique and powerful things that are sometimes left to the side. For me, music is an art form that's all about connection, and our program today will reflect this idea. We study connection on a very physical level in GTCYS, working first to be connected with ourselves and our instruments as we practice and hone our individual parts. And gradually, we transition over the course of a concert cycle to find connections within and around the orchestra. Orchestras play together, and rehearsals in any GTCYS orchestra are centered around this simple but powerful idea. We've also had the chance to learn about intellectual connection as we've studied together this year, and the ways in which composers create lasting works of art. You'll hear this in our first piece, Scherzo Fantasy, where composer Artin Arslanian takes a simple four-note motif and paints a breathtaking landscape of sound over the course of 8 minutes. You'll hear changes in tempo, color, texture, and rhythm, but each section is connected by that playful melodic idea that begins the piece. Then there's connection on a deeper, less corporeal level that music teaches us. And you'll hear this in Granger's Irish Tune from County Derry, a sorry song of farewell that uses sound to help us think about the people we love deeply that are no longer with us. Finally, we'll celebrate human connection and the feelings that bind us in our last piece, On Top of the World, a glorious work that celebrates the universal feeling of pride we have after accomplishing something worthwhile. Thank you for being here with us and supporting our students and the arts this morning. Enjoy the day's performances because our students are worth celebrating. Here is Scherzo Fantasy by Artin Arslanian.
Thank you so much. Good morning. Thank you for being here to support all of these young musicians. This is GTCYS Symphony, the oldest orchestra, and the orchestra that, as we heard from Arlo at the beginning of the concert, has the privilege of touring and representing the organization and the Twin Cities throughout the world. We tour every other year, and it just so happens that this is a non-tour year, but that each of these musicians is invited to join us on our tour next year, next summer, right around, well, a little later than a year from now, in mid-June, which will be to Provence and the south of France, and then to the Catalonia region, Barcelona, and around there. So, a horrible, horrible, no fun trip, you know. Very uninteresting, uncultural places. So, we're all gearing up to that and look forward to that. This orchestra, if each year, the GTCYS Symphony explores a pretty big symphony in the repertoire, usually the romantic repertoire, and we've had a concert about 3 weeks ago at Northrop Auditorium where we played Dvorak's New World Symphony, the complete New World Symphony. And if you've been attending concerts, the Fall Festival, for example, you heard kind of little snippets of that Dvorak. So that project is over, and now we have another big work, which we're essaying today for two concerts today and also one tomorrow. And that is Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet was inspired many, many composers, opera composers, symphonic composers, Leonard Bernstein and West Side Story. The story of Romeo and Juliet really was an instigator for so many. Tchaikovsky loved the story and thought there was great musical, dramatic potential, but couldn't actually figure out what it was going to be. First he started, it was going to be a symphony, then it was going to be some kind of other piece, and so he calls it, it's kind of a strange title, a fantasy overture. So it's not really an overture, it tells the whole story, but it's not meant to portray everything. Anyway, it's just kind of a free-form fantasy that Tchaikovsky has put together, full of great musical characterization. We have a beautiful chorale at the opening representing Friar Lawrence. We have, of course, a beautiful love theme presented to us by the English horn and the violas, and then the whole orchestra takes it over. We have, of course, the sword fights, just all sorts of drama. And naturally, a tragic ending. So it's been a piece that it's kind of hard to program in a way, but this is the perfect opportunity for us to not only have performed a great, substantial symphony during the year, but also this wonderful romantic work by Tchaikovsky. So please enjoy now Romeo and Juliet Overture Fantasy by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. Wow, thank you so much. That means everything to us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, as you well know, an organization like this and concerts like this and student experiences like this cannot happen without the support, not only, of course, tuition dollars, but also of donors. And we have started something called the Opportunity Fund, because we at GTCYS strongly, strongly believe that there should be no student who would be denied the opportunity to participate in the GTCYS program for monetary reasons. Every student who wants to and has interest and has the talent is welcome, and we will find a way through this Opportunity Fund to support that. Your support, if you choose to help us with this Opportunity Fund, provides high-quality instruction so every child in our program can meet their potential. Access for any child to participate, no matter what the financial situation. Inclusive programming, as you've heard today, for students of all levels, whoever want to play. Here's something really cool. We have a board member who's an alumnus, and who is actually the parent of two GTCYS alums, who is matching all donations in this month, up to $10,000. So if you, yeah, it's fantastic. If you are moved by what you hear, or you're about to be moved by what, I guarantee you'll be moved by what you're about to hear, your $50 contribution becomes $100, your $500 contribution becomes $1,000 because of this match. And so I, of course, strongly encourage you to take advantage of the great generosity of our board member alumnus. Whether it's your first gift, your 20th gift, no matter how large or how small, every gift matters in a big way. And like Arlo said, the experience for these students on tour, you know, we provide lots of scholarships for tours as well as tuition scholarships during the year, and so there's all sorts of wonderful reasons and all sorts of wonderful destinations for your donations. There are three ways to give online, gtcys.org/donate. You can drop off a check here with our staff in the lobby, or you can make a gift to the office, and the address is there is in your program. So thank you so much for your support and for considering that and helping with that match. It's a wonderful tradition. One more thing. Every one of these students on this stage, and I hope everybody has signed up for auditions for next year. Everybody, right? You guys have it down there? Okay. They're busy. Auditions deadline is pretty soon, and auditions are coming up. So make sure if you're going to participate next year. And I want every single student here on this stage to go on tour next year to perform. So anyway, we have a wonderful tradition at the end of our year. We're actually, since we have 10 orchestras, it would be impossible to have one program and all of us together. But to represent that, we come together at the end of each of the three concerts, kind of as a family, kind of as a benediction or a farewell to the season, and play a piece that's been a traditional goodbye for the season, even before I was here, and so I inherited this wonderful tradition. It's Jupiter from the Planets by Gustav Holst. The symphony will play the opening of it, and then all of us, all the orchestras, members of whom you've already heard, are in the aisles on stage up in the balconies. And so it's just a great way to end the season. And again, we thank you for your support of all of these young musicians, for our organization, for help in bringing beauty into a world that I dare say needs a lot more of it. And so thank you for playing your part in that. And now we conclude with Jupiter by Gustav Holst from the Planets.